That lady from the airline looked at him. She goes, "So your back is over 50 pounds? And for safety reasons, we can't put bags in excess of 50 pounds onto the flight." So I start to grab the bag. She goes, "But if you give us $100 more, we'll go ahead and throw it on the plane for you." I was like, "Well, that's great, but how does that fix the safety issue that you were just so concerned about? Let me get this straight. If I give you $100 more, you're going to turn on the extra safety features of this aeroplane." I'm like, "I didn't know that's how it worked. They shouldn't have gave me that kind of information. We were about to take off. Like, starting to put your seat up, we're about to take off. I just threw $100 at her." I was like, "Nope."
This looks so cool. And like, I know I don't look like this, but like, if I did.
I really want that guy who guesses people's height to do me.
Once again, I decided to go with the Dunkin' Donuts cup to test the accuracy of this method. Since we remember the top diameter was 3.75 inches, we can estimate his hand size to be about half the circumference. Next, I'm going to measure the flow of the air in his room. Just kidding. But I am going to use the width of this air vent as a reference for his chest size, which is 14 inches. To justify these measurements, I went ahead and found the dimensions of his microwave online. The diameter of the inner plate was 16 inches, so the estimation of 14 inches for chest size was pretty accurate. Next, we can set the hand size equal to y and solve using our equation, this time incorporating 1.02 for all the rough estimates. First, find the diameter of the Dunkin' Donuts cup, then divide that number by 2, multiply that number by 1.618, multiply that number by 2, add y, multiply again by 2 for both arms, add 14 for chest size, and multiply by 1.02 to get 65.18 inches, or about 5'5".
Proof that me and Caden are identical twins.
I'm sorry, what?
Okay, now switch.
Yo, it did it for a second.
Miss, the Jonas Brothers are back.
What? Oh my. Ah!
What?
Wait,
oh what?
Wait. Oh my God.
The Jonas Brothers are back.
That's freaking me out.
What?
They took a break.
I see that.
Now they're back.
They're gonna come back. I see y'all.
Yeah.
Doing y'all thing.
They're all married. He just got married.
No, congratulations.
Yes.
Yes, okay.
Which is your favorite Jonas?
Nick.
Oh, I'm sorry. I mean, oh, okay, well.
No, Joe, I got love for you too, Joe.
Well, Kevin, what about Kevin?
So I like the way your resume looks. It's pretty impressive, but what's the 4-year gap here?
Oh, those are the years that I went to Yale.
Wow, that's impressive. You know what? You're hired.
Ah, thanks, man. I really need this job.
Okay, stop. Look how freaking cool this is that I started doing, and I'm doing it like way too often. Okay, so you like, okay, I'll show you because it's freaking cool. Okay. Hi. Oh. Okay. Nice. Like, you just delay your words after you mouth them, so it looks like imagine coming up to, like, you're coming up to someone, you're coming up to meet them, and they go, hi. Like, wouldn't you be like, who just did that? Like that's odd. Like, hey. Isn't that so fun?
The number. I told you don't play with me, nigga. And she be acting funny, probably think a nigga needs. I thought I was fake, she say I'm a cheat. They thought I was taking, I'm ready to mingle. The fuck is you saying, little nigga? I do my little dancey dance. I've got my pen.
Yo.
Yo, not... no gay shit or whatever, but you are a sexy man.
Thank you, man. I appreciate
you. You are a sexy... Dude, wow.
You mean
no
that?
No gay shit.
You mean
no,
that?
I mean that 100%, dude. Like, you could fuck my girlfriend and I'd give you a high five after.
Yo.
Fuck, I don't know if I'm gay right now or straight as a pole.
What?
Wait.
What up, man?
You have a sister?
I don't have a sister. Yo.
Well, shit, you're kind of pretty, bro.
Oh, thank you, man. I appreciate that.
Yeah, that's good shit, bro. Good shit.
Good shit. What's up, man?
Dang, bro. Dang, you a fucking 10, G. You look like fucking Prince mixed with like a Chad, bro. Holy.
Give me your attention, baby. I gotta tell you a little something about yourself. You're wonderful, flawless, ooh, you a sexy lady. But you walk around here like you wanna be someone else. Ooh, whoa, I know that you don't know it, but you're fine, so fine.
Now listen, you only get to do this twice, so make it count.
Do you think it works with mini ear? Oh, no, that's a no. Oh, okay.
Cashmere. Girl, you ain't deaf. You got selective listening skills. Trying to play me. You ain't deaf. Hello, I'm trying to call you. I'm trying to get your attention. Duh. Which movie you want to watch?
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Yee-hoo! 5, 4, 3, 2, I let one go. Wow, get the f*** though. I don't bluff, bro.
Oh, to see without my eyes.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
Whoa! Whoa! Go! Whoa!
Your cell phone rings, you don't recognize the number, what do you do?
Ignore it.
Send it to voicemail. Yeah, not this guy. I answer it. Yeah, exactly. Opportunity, potential. Who knows? Who knows what it is? The other day I was driving down the 405, traffic. Phone rings, 917, New York. I'm like, oh, I don't know the number. I hit talk, I go, hello. Guy on the other line goes, hey, Bruce, what's going on? My name's Jay, not Bruce. So clearly I go, nothing much, man, what's going on with you? And he goes, I'll tell you what's going on. I just got an email about the budget. It's supposed to be 15,000, now it's 10,000. I'd like to know what the hell's going on. And I grab the steering wheel. I was like, all right, fucking focus. Focus right now. Your name is Bruce. There's a budget. It's 15,000, now it's 10. No one's happy about it. Just go with this. Go with this.
This is a warning. Don't ever go on Wago. I'm so scared right now.
Ew.
Hi.
How are you on with yourself right now?
Wait, you said ew at yourself.
Bitch.
Are you depressed?
This is not a child.
Get out of
there. Wait, talk to it.
Why am I?
I'm not an it.
So why you got my face?
I'm a...
Ew, take it! It's terrifying! Terrifying! Turn it off!
Guys.
Did you guys have someone that had your screen on their screen?
No.
No, but we had someone track our location.
Yeah, they had...
EA Sports. It's in the game.
EA Sports is in the game.
EA Sports is in the game.
EA Sports is in the game.
EA Sports, it's in the game.
EA Sports is in the game, yes.
EA Sports is in the game.
EA Sports is in the game.
EA Sports is in the game.
EA Sports, it's in the game.
EA Sports is in the game.
EA Sports, it's in the game.
After looking at the evidence, EA Sports is in the game.
EA Sports is in the game.
Yo, we gotta talk about the pyramids. The Great Pyramids are built literally in the mathematical exact center of the world. This means that the Egyptians knew that the Earth was around literally thousands of years before the first official discovery of the round Earth. This means that they knew exactly how big the Earth was and had way more geometric knowledge than we think they did. And the Great Pyramid of Giza's coordinates are literally the exact speed of light. Think about that, that's literally crazy. Look at these numbers, the Egyptians had this down to the 7th decimal place. Means that either the Egyptians were way more advanced than we thought they were, or, hear me out here, aliens. Egyptian hieroglyphs always depict godlike beings coming down and teaching them essential skills to survival, such as irrigation of soil. The pyramids that the Aztecs built in South America depict the exact same thing. Telling me cultures that had no contact with each other on opposite ends of the globe came up with the exact same stories about the exact same beings coming down and teaching them the exact same thing? Yo, there's just no way. Look how big these things are. The Pyramid of Giza is still the largest standing structure on Earth. You're telling me that a civilization who apparently their most advanced technological innovation was getting a camel to drag a sled across sand created these? And you're telling me that in these giant time capsules, the Egyptians were depicting fabricated beings that taught them skills that they already knew how to do? Nah.
No! No! You hit the fucking...
No, he hit the light. I'm punching that.
Julio, just hug me.
Quit.
Stop!
Quit!
He's gonna fuck me!
So I made Yondu's arrow from Guardians of the Galaxy that actually flies when you whistle. I know this kind of seems impossible, like an arrow that changes direction mid-flight. Well, in the movies, they use sound-sensitive metal. But if we want something that's actually physically possible, we gotta go with like wings or rockets or something. So first, let's try rockets.
Oh,
yeah, never mind. Let's try wings. Alright, wings work better, but still doesn't really look like an arrow. But then I tried a tiny racing drone. Basically, I built it with all the weight in the back. It actually looks like an arrow too, with the drone hidden in the back where the feathers of the arrow would be. And it can actually fly through stuff too. And lastly, to make it whistle controlled, I wrote a little program that takes the pitch of your whistle and triggers a remote to send the drone forwards or backwards. So when you whistle low, it goes forward, and whistle high, it goes backwards. And just like that, we got a working Yondu arrow that flies when you whistle.
Zaza, it goes straight to the mata. Then I'm up in the chopper, hitting the cha-cha. Open his lata, then he dancing my chata. Up in the Zaza, it goes straight to the mata. Then I'm up in the
chopper. Slam, slam, oh hot damn.
Babe, that was beautiful.
Was it?
Yeah, who sings it?
Pink, I think.
Yeah, well let them fucking sing it, you sound
when a blackjack dealer calls you his lucky charm. When you have to be funny because being hot is not an option. When you get tagged and freeze tag as you're running to the bathroom. Ha ha ha! when your grandpa with dementia calls you a sexy young lady? When you eat an apple a day, but you still get COVID. Did you spill red paint on your carpet? Well, here's how to help. Oh my god, I'm gonna get in trouble. It's totally not just red water in here. Hey, boy, back up. You wanna smudge it and pour more water. Actually, just pour it all on my dumb self. You wanna scrub the excess off and totally get it on your pants, you know, to get extra stains. Works very well. Then you want to scrub as hard as you can, like as hard as you can, because baby, I'm finna get my butt whooped, my bleep butt whooped, or whatever I just said. Like, scrub hard. And then for entertainment, put shaving cream. If I don't post in the next 24 hours, I'm dead. I'm done with the fucking bodies in the lake, obliterating everything is iterated, renegade. I'm gonna make anybody who want it with a pen and frame.
Don't nobody want it, but they're gonna get it anyway. I'm beginning to feel like I'm mentally ill. Have you ever had a dream that you had, you could do?
Glass bottom boat.
Looks so perfect standing there in my American Apparel underwear. And I know now that I'm so down.
What you want to do is try to balance these coins and...
Yeah, now I'm panicking. Yeah,
don't panic.
No, I am, because I'm going to lose my job.
Sit. Fuck, gang, you good? Damn, my shoulder, you know this bitch.
You'd be walking up the stairs like this. My shoes looking real shoey today. Damn, I didn't know that these rails was made of rail. That's crazy.
Is it a YouTube?
I guess you'll never know.
No, I wanna know.
No.
I was like, wait, give it to me. Wait. Give it to me. Wait.
I got guns in my head and they won't go.
Spirits in my head and they won't go.
I got guns in my head and they won't go.
Spirits in my head and they won't go.
I got guns in my head and they won't go.
Spirits in my head and they won't go.
So my boyfriend told me he doesn't love me anymore.
Katie, I didn't say that. All I said was I didn't want to give you a back massage while I would listen to Justin Bieber's Christmas album on repeat.
So you don't love me?
You've been listening to it for the past 3 hours.
Is this allowed? I don't think this is allowed on TikTok. I don't think... Oh. Well, why did it have veins, though?
Out of any episode in SpongeBob, I have one suspicious episode. Now, why in the world did they go on a panty raid?
I guess you're gonna miss the panty raid.
Panty raid? You're talking about girls, right? Girls?
Yeah.
And you're talking about raiding their dressers for their underpants, right?
Oh yeah.
What did they do with those panties?
2020 just got even crazier. We all know this mysterious monolith that was found in the middle of nowhere in Utah, right? Well, it has suddenly disappeared and no one really knows where it went. Just a little time after people found that mysterious monolith, a second one was just found across the globe in Romania. After this monolith was found, it disappeared also. Now that brings us to the third one that was just found in California. No one really knows what's going on. Yeah, if that's not weird enough, a mysterious object is flying towards Earth right now. And scientists actually believe this mysterious object is a part of a rocket that crashed into the moon in 1966. Okay, and finally, this has left a lot of scientists stunned. The moon is actually starting to rust. So what's next, 2020?
I just saw this girl do this thing where she made herself look like she's glitching by saying, you know how you can like talk under, like without moving your mouth, like, hi, like that? If you do that, but you mouth the words a second before, so imagine walking up to your friend like, hi. And they're like, what the fuck did you just, where did that come from? Or like, hey. That looks so funny.
Here are some tips that could actually save your life one day. Firstly, if you're ever getting chased by a polar bear, just know they have insane ADHD. So all you have to do is drop something small, like a hat or glove, and the polar bear will stop and sniff it, and you will have time to get away. But if you're ever getting chased by another bear, do not climb a tree because they are great climbers. Instead, run down a hill because bears are not good at running down hills because they gain too much speed. Next, if you ever end up falling in the sky without a parachute, firstly, you do not want to land on water because water will feel like concrete. You need to put your body into an X shape. This will slow down your fall. Your three best options for landing is a swamp, snow, or trees. Also, you want to land on your feet. This will absorb some of your impact, and this will give you the best chance of living. Finally, if you ever notice a car is following you, do not go back to your house. Well, first, you need to make four right turns to see if they're actually following you. But if they are, you need to go to a police station immediately.
Andrew, hold these. Hold these with your palms, like that.
Okay.
See if you're strong.
Oh.
Okay, those pretty strong, heavy. Pretty strong. I got some heavier ones. Let's see. What about these?
How much is that?
Like 15s.
Okay. Oh.
Can you?
It's heavy.
Okay. Okay, see if you can hold that for 10 seconds.
10?
Let's see. Let's see if you got it.
10.
You think you can do it?
Yes. 8. 7. Why is that? Why are you putting ketchup
what?
On? What? What?
So me and my older brother just went to Walmart and bought our little brother some deodorant and a body wash because he smells like a Funyun, and so we thought we'd be nice and get him a Black Panther because that's his favorite.
Yeah, he really likes Marvel.
So we're gonna get his reaction.
Okay, we're gonna get his reaction.
Okay, so I got you this because you smell like a Funyun. Here you go. It's deodorant and body wash.
Ow. The other day, I was playing a random game of Among Us.
And right after I joined the lobby, someone named Addison joined.
So I asked Addison if she was a girl, and she said yes.
I had more questions for Addison, though, so right when the game started, I raced to call a
meeting. I had to find out how old Addison was, so I asked her that
first. She told me that she was 21.
And then she said something weird after
that. She told me that she was single.
So it kind of seemed like Addison was hitting on me.
Everyone else in the lobby was very mad that me and Addison were flirting with each other.
They said Among Us is not a dating app, and they told us to download Tinder.
But after that, me and Addison started doing every task together.
But then something bad happened.
Purple killed me right in front of Addison.
I was so upset because I couldn't talk to Addison anymore.
Addison asked everyone to vote her out so she could be with
Nobody
me.
Has ever done something like that for me before, so I called Addison
and
pretty.
And then she asked to FaceTime me, so I gave her my
right
number.
Right after that, a random number started calling me, so it had to be Addison.
I was so excited to talk to Addison and see what she looked like.
So, you really think I'm pretty?
Gotta do what I gotta do.
I have this a mystery box.
Uh-huh.
Basically, the value of this could be something exponential. If you want to give me $20, it could be yours.
No, I don't want to do that.
I'm kind of begging you to take it for $20.
No, I'll pass.
Let me just say, this will be the single greatest investment of your life at $20.
I'm going to pass, all right? You're gonna pass. I have no idea. Yep. Sorry.
Well, all right. Well, let's at least see what you missed out on.
All right.
Well, let's see. You could have had $6,000.
Oh, my gosh. $6,000, huh?
If you would have taken the box.
Let me see one of them.
Well, no.
Oh, my gosh. Are you serious? You swear to God, if I gave you $20, that would all have been mine.
Yeah. You know what they say? Sometimes you got to take the gamble.
Yeah. Ну, видишь рыбу?
Ну, прикусывает, да?
Ну, так вот у него молоденькие, зубки остренькие, но неприятно так. Ну, нет, он никак. Вот я рыбу буду держать. Нет. Вообще сосиску держишь, прям вот ему даешь, он ждет, пока руку не вынешь. Что, встать тяжело, да? Слишком сильно ты поправился.
Только такой кормит.
Thank you, Honey Bunny.
Honey Bunny, I'm not sweet. I ain't nothing sweet about me.
So you ugly? You're not sweet, you ugly?
Do I call you Honey Bun?
You can call me, no problem.
All right, Cupcake.
Thank you.
All right.
Sweetie Pie.
I just wanna be a free shadow.